artery disease, does not help. So people ask me, what is coronary artery disease? I'll put it this way. If hair can gray, eyes can develop a cataract, cells can age to develop cancer, coronary arteries with age can develop a block. So you call it coronary artery disease. Now we have three funny situations. Arteries which are plumb normal can end up in heart attack. In arteries which are advanced block, the person carrying on up to 80 years of age, we have not been able to connect coronary blockage with heart disease. We have not. And secondly, a person comes to you, you look at the angiogram, and then now there is trouble. When you look at angiogram, the same angiogram shown to the same cardiologist on three different occasions, three different reading, the same angiogram shown to three cardiologists, three different reading, till today, we do not know whether angiogram is read well or not. But more than anything, nature does bypasses on its own. If your heart is working well, you may have multiple blockage. There is no need to tamper with the blockage on one simple principle, which is known as principle of garbage clearance. Ahmedabad is a clean city. Bombay is not. Bombay is sone ke lote mein gutter ka pani, right? But in Bombay, I see for myself that the garbage is never removed. It is relocated elsewhere. From my house it is taken and dumped behind Mother Teresa's home in Borivali, near, well beyond, close to the sea coast. In any city, garbage is never removed, it is relocated. Today America has got 6 million garbage dumps. It doesn't know what to do. If you have a coronary garbage, say my coronaries are clogged, and if you do bypass, or if you do angioplasty, you dislodge the garbage. It goes to the path of least resistance, it goes to the brain. Ladies and gentlemen, New England of Medicine, 2002, avers the fact that during bypass and angioplasty, the brain is damaged in 100% of cases. That the kachra taken out from the coronary goes straight to the brain and causes minor to major symptoms. It manifests itself in 54% of people, ranging from mild depression to a stroke. And therefore, bypass is dangerous. Angioplasty is dangerous. And above everything, the stent which is there is anti-physiologic, because the function of the artery is to contract, then expand, contract and expand. With a stent, the artery is paralyzed in dilate. Distension, the artery is destroyed. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, some doctors are here, they can refer to Harrison's Principle of Internal Medicine, now in two volumes. Till 1980 it was in one volume, 8th edition, two volumes, now to the 16th edition. For the last 25 years, one particular paragraph does not change, namely on coronary bypass. And it goes as follows: we do not know how bypass works. Why they have said that quite often after doing bypass, the bypass closes down in 3 months, but the patient remains well. Therefore, the following are the three theories. One, placebo effect. Kharaj karne ka anand, sabse badi baat. In coronary, kharaj karne ka anand. And one angiography text says that in as many as 64% of people, the heart remains unchanged, but he feels nice. That after all, spending 5 lakhs of rupees, I must feel nice. Even the wife would say that I have sold my Mangat Sutra, now at least today you should feel nice. The second is sensory neurectomy. The nerves are cut. The heart remains boxed as before, but the fellow doesn't develop a frenzied reaction. I was told about Ahmedabad. One doctor was driving and took a sharp left turn. So the wife says, "Tame aa turn karso mane bahu dar lage." So husband says, "You do what I do." She says, "What?" He says, "I close my eyes and take the turn." So when you do sensory neurectomy, the heart remains boxed up as before, but you don't know. And finally, the textbook says, which you can confirm, mostly, he says, mostly, bypass relieves pain by infarcting the ischemic segment. Moral of the story, bypass relieves your pain by killing that segment of your heart which before bypass was complaining. During bypass, that segment dies, the nerves in that segment dies, the nerve in that segment dies, your pain disappears. Jang jitiyo re maro kaniyo, vau chale tab janiyo, you know. So bypass becomes a way of doing, Gujaratis will understand, tamare jo lakh na 12,000 karva hoy, to bypass karo. See. Now somebody will say that after all so many people survive, but you may survive despite the bypass. You are forgetting that you may survive despite the bypass. I'll tell you what, angiography started in 1952. Bypass started in about 1956. Angioplasty started in 1966. But you will be surprised that the whole business of bypass is exactly 106 years old because it started first in 1899. But it is vaniya vaniya, phir bhi toda. Either this procedure, that procedure. I must tell you that till today, bypass angiography, angioplasty and stent, unfortunately, do not have any scientific validity. None. None. There is no drug which we can safely prescribe, none. In fact, most drug prescribed for heart weaken the heart. Doctors go by this theory that his heart allegedly receives less blood, so the heart should work less. So they give drugs for the heart to work less, beta blocker, calcium channel blockers, ACE inhibitors, so the heart works less, so heart gives out less blood, so the coronary receives less blood. Therefore, like in cancer, all cardiac drugs end up hurting the heart. So what should we do? Simple. A, accept that with age, heart, like your hair, should age. Clear? Kshayate iti kshariram. Secondly, a diseased heart is no parvana for death. A healthy heart is no parvana for life. Therefore, to my heart patients, I give them three mantras. Firstly, Allah mehrban to insaan pehlwan. Secondly, Ram rakhega to mujhe koi nahi chakhega. And thirdly, Ram chakhega to doctor ko bhi koi nahi rakhega. First,